WJHG TV 7, Panama City.
Good morning, everyone. Tuesday, and I don't know, very humid out this morning here along the Gulf Coast, and we hope it's pleasant where you are. There's no two ways about it. Here in the Southland, it's hot as a dickens. But anyway, we're not going to complain. That goes with the territory in July. And what is pleasant, though, is to say good morning to you, invite you to have a cup of coffee with us, and enjoy the Daybusters show. An hour of music, news, community happenings, time signals, weather information, guests along the way this morning. In fact, it's going to be somewhat of a busy week. We hope you'll stick around with us and have that coffee and help us launch today. Amy Hoyt will be on deck in just a moment with first edition news and weather. Cindy's riding shotgun today. Isn't that nice? Okay, she'll take care of that. And let's see, Uncle Mike was singing on his way to work. And let's see, we've got a couple of features for you this morning we think you'll enjoy. So all in all, we hope it'll be kind of a laid-back way to launch your Tuesday. And let's see, this is the 14th day of the month. We hope you'll stick around for the Daybusters program. It's nice to have you with us. Fools rush in, and you can see why we're on the run this morning.
Thank you.
this morning we'll be talking to Dick Van Dyke in Hollywood. We hope you'll stay tuned. He has a special coming on later this week. We'll be talking about that. Right now, though, it's 7 minutes past the hour, Central Time. And we would like to say good morning to Amy Hoyt in First Edition News and Weather. Welcome aboard, Amy.
Thanks, Tom. Good morning. The state fire marshal's office ruled today that arson was the cause of the fire which destroyed the home of suspended Walton County Commissioner Raymond Hall. We get details from TV7's Glenn Austin.
Early July 4th, suspended Walton County Commissioner Raymond Hall's house burned down. When the state fire marshal's office was called in, tests were performed on the property. Today, the results of those tests showed that the fire was started by an arsonist. Ron McArdle from the state fire marshal's office said that the fire was started by an incendiary device, which caused $100,000 worth of damage. Early reports that Raymond Hall had received threats could not be substantiated by the state fire marshal's office. Hall was suspended from office by Governor Bob Martinez after he allegedly stole $11,000 worth of merchandise from the county. Meanwhile, the Florida Advisory on Arson Prevention is offering up to $1,000 or more for information leading to the identification of the person responsible for starting the fire that burned Raymond Hall's house down. In Walton County, Glenn Austin, TV7 News.
Officials from the Florida Game and Freshwater Fish Commission have identified the man attacked and killed by an alligator at Wakulla Springs State Park yesterday. George Cummins of Tallahassee snorkeled downstream about 400 yards from the roped-off swimming area and right into an area where hundreds of alligators are known to live. Game wardens wounded a 10-foot gator believed to have been involved in the attack. They hope to capture it and perform an autopsy. The incident is the first known alligator attack at Wakulla Springs. Four squadrons of the 325th Tactical Training Wing at Tyndall Air Force Base conducted change of command ceremonies yesterday. TV7's David Reinhart was there.
The four squadrons of the 325th Tactical Training Wing, which underwent change of command at Tyndall Air Force Base on Monday morning, are all responsible for the maintenance of the aircraft and aircraft equipment on the base. The 325th Maintenance Training Squadron, the 325th Component Repair Squadron, the 325th Equipment Maintenance Squadron, and the 325th Aircraft Generation Squadron all have new commanders. Lieutenant Colonel Marvin O. Clark is the new commander of the Aircraft Generation Squadron. AGS is responsible for the overall maintenance of the aircraft on the flight line. The former commander of AGS, Lieutenant Colonel Michael Luffred, has been promoted to Assistant Deputy Commander for Maintenance at Tyndall. Major James T. Putnam will assume command of the Equipment Maintenance Squadron. He moves up from the Component Repair Squadron. The new commander of the CRS is Major Robert G. Sloan. Sloan is the former commander of the 325th Maintenance Training Squadron. He is being replaced in that position by Captain Gary Hamilton. Hamilton's position is temporary until a permanent commander can be named. The 325th Maintenance Training Squadron is responsible for training all of the mechanics for the F-15 Eagles in Air Force inventory. Each commander is moving to a larger squadron and is assuming increased responsibilities. From Tyndall Air Force Base, David Reinhart, TV7 News.
Motorists traveling westbound on 23rd Street near Drummond Avenue were startled to find their path blocked after a section of the roadway collapsed. Department of Transportation spokesperson Steve Potter explains what caused the gap in the road.
Contractor was doing a boring operation in order to put a pipe underneath the roadway for Southern Bell. And in the course of that operation, it has caused a void to occur underneath the roadway, and it finally fell in today.
How'd y'all discover it?
A lady happened to be trying to make a left-hand turn when her car sunk down into the hole.
Traffic had to be rerouted around the area as workers refilled the hole. By the way, no one was injured in the early afternoon mishap. Arson has been blamed for a mid-afternoon fire that caused about $5,000 damage to a vacant home on Skurlock Lane in Southport. The home, owned by the Gaynor family, had been unoccupied for some time. Fire Chief Earl Pettis said a vagrant had been staying there and firemen suspected the unknown transient started the blaze. Units for Lynn Haven and Southport Fire Departments answered the alarm. The State Fire Marshal's office is investigating. And the weather forecast promises to be a mostly sunny day, a 40% chance of showers, and a high temperature of about 93 degrees.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's a good song, Junior. That'd be real good, right up there. Okay. Couldn't remember the exact, sooner or later, now and then, and we knew that wasn't exactly true. But Mr. Lolley, we finally came up with it, and it's okay. Let's see, let's check it right now. 12 minutes past the hour. Once in a while. Is that right, Junior? We got to figure it out now?
I don't know.
Okay. You don't even care, do you? Do you care, Mike? All right.
Microwave ovens are great for cooking, but to take advantage of them to their fullest, you've really got to remember a few very simple rules. Once you've mastered them, you'll be able to cook many foods in a variety of manners, as well, if not better, than in a conventional stovetop or oven.
For most microwave owners, some of these tips have become second nature.
It's important to stir the food and turn the dish so the food heats evenly.
Since the food is still cooking when it comes out of the microwave, you have to let it stand for a few minutes.
But the key factor is convenience. That's why using convenience foods, where some of the work has already been done, fits in nicely with many microwave techniques.
For convenient one-dish meals, like chicken and stuffing, place the larger pieces around the outside and partially cook them. For the foods that cook more quickly, like stuffing, place it in the center and finish cooking them together.
Another quick trick helps solve one of the main microwave complaints, its inability to create an appetizing appearance in some foods. To add sauce and flavor to foods like chicken parts, after removing the skin, toss them in a mix like shake-and-bake barbecue. This coating will turn the chicken an appealing color. And with no chicken skin, there's less fat and calories. Frozen vegetables are one of the most used convenience foods. And microwaving frozen vegetables can have important health and taste advantages.
Frozen vegetables can be microcooked without adding water. This helps retain water-soluble vitamins and minerals, as well as flavor and color.
As consumer research indicates that microwaves will be found in 75% of all U.S. households by 1990, more and more Americans are relearning how to cook by catching that big microwave. This is Bob Lape reporting.
by the way, we have a couple of weeks to talk about it, but I think it's a good idea to mention. Appreciate a letter I received from the Zayer Company here in Panama City. Judy Cook, the assistant store manager, dropped a note to us. An event that's up and coming. The Zayer employees and their families are presenting a flea market yard sale with all proceeds going to muscular dystrophy. This will be on August 1st from 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. in the parking lot in front of the Zayer store, 1380 West 15th Street, Panama Plaza, the corner of Lisenby and 15th. And by the way, donations from the public are appreciated and welcome, and the donations are now being accepted through Wednesday, July 29th. And then Saturday, August 1st, please come and shop with them and take advantage of the terrific bargains. Thanks to Judy Cook letting us know about the big flea market sale at Zayer's on August 1st. That's great. We hope you folks will respond. I better put that in the file and we'll hit that a number of times. Good idea, right, Junior? As we enter the trading post, the swapping pole, whatever, anything to buy, sell, trade, give away, fence, hawk, whatever, write to us at Box 2349, Panama City, Florida. After the program and during the day, no calls to the station. Information will not be given nor taken by phone. Call Dick Van Dyke. He'd get a kick out of it.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, he'd love that. Okay, what have you got?
All right. We have a 25-inch black and white TV. I'm going to sell it for $150. Also have a radio, AM and FM, with tape for $150. For either or both, call 785-2451. 785-2451. And we have a 10-inch Rockwell table saw. Excellent condition. Used around the house only.
Well, that makes sense. It's hard to carry in your car with you.
Yeah. Also, a brand new 7-inch dado blade.
That's a dado blade.
Dado blade.
Uh-huh. That cuts one of them.
Cuts
you
a
know,
dado.
Uh-huh. Everybody has one of them, right?
Yeah, everybody ought to have one of them. It's got a carbide tip. That's the best kind. And you can buy all of it for $225. Call in the evenings only at 265-8667. 265-8667.
Paris got a carbide.
And we have for sale AKC registered 8 months old female Yorkshire Terrier. Very small, 3.5 pounds. Baby doll face. Silky, correct coat, correct color, all shots. Good with children. Perfect bit in her mouth. I never can understand
never
that. I didn't
so
know.
It's hard to saddle them, though, if you get the bit.
Yeah, 3.5 pounds, you'd have to have a little saddle.
Tiny thing, short legs.
Got erect ears. They stand for loving home. And you can buy all of her for $500 or best offer. Call during the daytime at 784-4848, 784-4848. Or in the evenings, you can call 784-3035. And we have 8 laying hens, well fed and fat, asking $4 each. And if they ain't laying, they're lying, he says. Call in the early mornings or after dark. Before the rooster gets up.
Before the rooster gets up, right.
Call 785-0057. 785-0057.
Ask for anxious.
Yeah. You know, if they quit laying, they're also good with dumplings.
That's right.
Looking for homes for 4 healthy kittens, 2 orange males and 2 black and white females. These kittens are 8 weeks old and free to a good home. Call after 6 p.m. at 235-1735. 235-1735. Call after 6 p.m. or any time on weekends. And we have for sale a clean and excellent condition 1986 Ranger V6 XL. Loaded, power steering, automatic transmission, power brakes, AM, FM radio, stereo cassette deck, extra speakers, air conditioning, new tires, aluminum camper shell. And we must sell this one. Ask in $1,000 and take over the payments. You can call between 7 and 3 at 769-9173. 769-9173. Or between 5 and 3 p.m., you can call 784-6637. Have some golf balls for sale. $5 a dozen, like new. You can go by and pick them up at 2321 Joan Avenue on the beach. That's what he done. Or you can call them at 235-4842. 235-4842.
No guess there's any water hazards near there.
No, I guess not. And for sale, a 1980 280 ZX. It's loaded, new tires, AM, FM radio with tape deck, tinted windows, and they're asking $5,000 for it. This is real nice. Also have a 17-foot Thunderbird boat with an 85 Johnson, new marine battery. The trailer is included. It runs good. It's a 1966 model, but it's in excellent condition, and it's priced at $2,000. For either, call after 6 p.m. at 785-9777. That's 785-9777.
Okay, that's it for the Q Trading Post. Anything to buy, sell, trade, give away, if it's non-commercial, write to us, Box 2349, Panama City, Florida. After the program, during the day, no calls to the station, please. We're coming up 23 minutes past the hour. Let's check our tri-state and local weather, and here's Amy Hoy.
Thank you, Tom. Once again, good morning, everyone. A typical summer day around the nation with rain anticipated. Taking a look at the national weather map at this time, showers and thunderstorms will reach from the Tennessee Valley across North Carolina, also from Virginia, across New England and New York State. Much of the nation will have high temperatures in the 80s and 90s. Temperatures will reach 100 to 110 degrees from southwest Oregon across much of eastern California through the desert southwest. Earlier this morning, temperatures ranged from 40 degrees in Hibbing, Montana to 92 at Phoenix, Arizona. A little closer to home, a large cluster of very heavy thunderstorms was over the coast and immediate coastal waters of Okaloosa and Santa Rosa counties, with the larger and heaviest storm around the Navarre area. The thunderstorms were moving slowly north. The marine forecast: from Apalachicola to Pensacola today, west and southwest winds near 10 knots, seas running about 2 to 3 feet, a light chop in protected waters, winds and seas higher near scattered thunderstorms. Tonight, variable, mostly northwest winds near 10 knots, seas running 2 to 3 feet with a light chop once again, winds and seas higher near scattered thunderstorms. Taking a look at our local forecast, partly cloudy skies today, 40% chance of thunderstorms, look for a high of about 93 degrees, winds will be from the west, 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy with a 20% chance of thunderstorms, low in the mid-70s. And tomorrow, more of the same, mostly sunny, a 30% chance of rain, and a high in the low 90s. Currently outside our studios at TV7, we have 80 degrees.
She blows, bar she blows, hump like a snow hill. It is Moby Dick. The men on deck rushed to the rigging to behold the famous whale they'd been so long pursuing. I breach your last to the sun, Moby Dick. Thy hour and thy harpoon are at hand.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Oh, Grandpa.
What are you reading? Moby Dick, great story. Say, this is a beautiful book. I haven't seen a ray spine like this in years. See this finish? Protects pages inside. Attractive end papers, too.
Yeah, and check out those illustrations.
They just don't make books like this anymore.
Sure they do. We just got this one.
It must have cost a fortune.
Nowhere near a fortune, Dad.
Well, at least $30 or $40.
More like $14.50.
This book was $14.50? That's less than what most ordinary books cost.
We ordered it from the Franklin Library. I'm reading Anna Karenina.
You ordered these books by mail?
Sure. We get a new one every month.
Quite a collection. Wuthering Heights, The Odyssey, Vanity Fair, all the great classics.
And some moderns like Faulkner and James Joyce.
And each of these books is only $14.50?
Only $14.50.
Well, maybe I ought to get in on this, too.
To subscribe, just call the Franklin Library, and we'll send you Moby Dick to examine without obligation. You'll receive another classic each month, printed on acid-free paper to last for generations, each with its own distinctive cover. Each book is only $14.50. You'll never pay more. This price is guaranteed for your entire subscription. Order by credit card or pay COD with a $1 service charge. You may return any book for any reason within 30 days and cancel any time.
Hey, Grandpa.
Hmm?
Does Captain Ahab get the great whale?
Aye, if Moby Dick doesn't get him first.
Call for your collector's library and discover the pride of owning the world's greatest books. There's no risk. Call now and we'll start you with your copy of Moby Dick.
That wriggler falling into the water is a mosquito larvae. Keep your eye on it. That fish called a gambusia minnow could be an economical natural way to control mosquitoes. This is one aspect of the work going on at the University of South Carolina's Public Health Research Center, located on a former rice plantation. It has ideal breeding environments for tropical and subtropical insects like mosquitoes, which spread malaria and other diseases. Dr. Mac Tidwell, the center's director, collects 2,000 mosquitoes in a single trap during one night.
Those are great.
The captured mosquitoes are bred to produce larvae for study.
Okay,
and these are not the same species that currently spread malaria, but they are related closely enough to test new methods of control. Besides the minnows that eat the larvae, the researchers have found another fish that eats the plants that sheltered the newly hatched insects. Foreign students who study at the center would take the new disease control methods back to their tropical homeland. So the fight to control malaria may soon be going once again in man's favor, thanks to these new control techniques, fish versus mosquitoes. This report was produced with the support of the National Science Foundation and the General Motors Research Laboratories. This is Don Herbert.
A lot of people who don't think they need a hearing aid may already have one.
Up two streets, take a right.
He said up two streets and take a right.
They bring their hearing aid with them wherever they go.
What'd he say?
He said he doesn't want to leave her, but he has to.
And if they forget their hearing aid, they'll find one.
Vinaigrette. She said Italian, Thousand Island, or vinaigrette?
Vinaigrette.
Now there's a hearing aid for people reluctant to wear one. It's called Miracle Ear. Because hard as it may be to believe, that's precisely what it is. If you have nerve deafness and have been told nothing can be done for you, Miracle Ear could help. If you can hear people talk but can't understand all the words, Miracle Ear could help. If you're concerned how a hearing aid will make you look, people probably won't even know you're wearing a Miracle Ear unless you tell them. Miracle Ear is so tiny, it's practically unnoticeable, but a hearing problem can be very noticeable.
Next?
She said next.
Oh.
Still reluctant? Maybe you need more information. Call 1-800-352-2300 and receive this free booklet. You'll get the facts you need to make an informed, intelligent decision about your hearing needs and which steps, if any, to take next. You'll even learn how you can get a free hearing test. Just call 1-800-352-2300.
Huh?
He said, speak now or forever hold your peace.
Oh. Ask your doctor about Miracle Ear or call 1-800-352-2300. The phone call is free. The helpful information is free. Our hearing test is also free. Call Miracle Ear now, because when you're losing your hearing, the worst thing to do is nothing.
What did he say? Breakfast deal at McDonald's.
McDonald's, what is it?
Place with the golden arches. Ronald, all that?
No, what's the deal?
Breakfast sandwich deal. Costs under a dollar to take breakfast by the hand.
Which one?
Oh, either one, right, left.
Which breakfast sandwich?
The three biscuit sandwiches. Sausage, sausage with egg, bacon, egg, and cheese, plus egg McMuffin and sausage McMuffin with egg.
Oh, can't miss that.
Five breakfast sandwiches, each under a dollar.
Ah, taking breakfast by the hand, eh?
That
thing at the end of your arm.
During Daybusters, we feature music showcase singers or musical groups who have caught our attention, resulting in their performances being videotaped in our studio. We're always looking for good singers or groups and invite you to send audio tapes for audition purposes. These may be cassettes, reel-to-reel, whole, half, or quarter track tapes. If you'd like to be considered, call area 904-234-2125 and ask for Daybuster Audition.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Amy Hoyt. In the news, a 22-year-old Bay County woman has been ordered to appear in a Savannah, Georgia court August 5th in connection with the beating death of her 12-month-old baby. Circuit Judge Fred Turner ordered Tawana Weaver to appear. She had refused to testify against her husband, 24-year-old Elijah Weaver, who's accused of beating the baby to death and crushing its heart because it would not stop crying. Georgia prosecutor Jeff Hendricks told the court Weaver is influencing his wife not to testify before a grand jury. The Destin Lagoon in Okaloosa County may be the first body of water in the state of Florida to be designated a federal no-discharge zone. Glenn Austin has details.
The Destin Lagoon has been plagued with pollution problems for years. City and county officials have been struggling to find solutions to the problems, but so far have come up empty. The latest step taken by the city could be the beginning of the answer. Last January, Mitch Dudley, the harbor master, submitted a petition asking for the harbor to be designated a no-discharge zone. Last Friday, an inspector from the Environmental Protection Agency inspected the harbor. Before leaving, he told city officials that the harbor has met all the criteria to become a federal no-discharge zone. But final designation won't happen until after the paperwork is finished in Tallahassee and a 45-day waiting period for public comment has been completed. This will probably be around mid-September. If the area is designated a no-discharge zone, the Destin Lagoon will not only be the first body of water in Florida given that designation, but it will also be the only body of water given that designation in Region 4 of the Southeast, which includes South Carolina, Georgia, Alabama, Mississippi, and Florida. What this means to the boating public in Destin is that they will no longer be able to dump treated or untreated water into the lagoon. If they do, then they could be fined $1,000 and or sentenced to a year in jail. While the final ruling won't be made until this September, Destin officials were told by the EPA that paperwork is only a formality, and the Destin Lagoon should be designated a no-discharge zone. In Destin, Glenn Austin, TV7 News.
School Superintendent Leonard Hall's attorney Fred Johnson has filed a protection order in the hopes of keeping Hall from giving a deposition in the lawsuit filed against him. The school board and Mowat Middle School principal Joel Creel. Johnson has also asked the courts to grant Hall a time of extension for producing certain documents. More than 40 parents, teachers, and students filed the suit back in May against the book selection and review policy. The suit states that the policy violates basic First Amendment rights and that the banning of I Am the Cheese is unconstitutional. The weather forecast, mostly sunny skies expected. However, there is a 40% chance of rain. Look for a warm temperature this afternoon of about 93 degrees. And that's a look at news. It's Tuesday, and it's time now for a medical report with Dr. Red Duke.
You know, this is a great time of year to have a picnic. At least we think so. But let me tell you, there's a bunch of other critters that feel the same way. Like bees, ants, wasps, and a whole assortment of other critters that climb, crawl, and fly. Now, the average insect bite or sting is not much more than just a nuisance to most of us. Now, for some folks, though, an insect bite or sting can be a life-threatening event. Every year, 200 or 300 people die from these bites and stings because they're allergic to the poison that these animals put in them.
You never know if the first thing that you get may be the sensitizing dose so that you're allergic basically for their own.
Now, most of the time, life-threatening allergic reactions to insect stings are preceded by several episodes in which there is some kind of other problem, like a rash all over your body or an asthmatic attack, wheezing when you're breathing. These attacks are serious and should not be ignored.
At that point, you're in trouble. An oral antihistamine may be helpful while you're moving to a medical facility. But folk who have known allergies to insect stings, you really have, your best choice is to get desensitized.
Now, I can't emphasize enough the importance of getting desensitization shots if your experience is anything more than local swelling at the site of a sting. It could save your life. Don't bug bugs, and they won't bug you. I'm Dr. Red Deer.
Tell you what, the old tree with a beard is here this morning, Eldon Haddock, Haddock's Garden Center, 3302 West 23rd Street. You know, this is a critical time of the year. I don't think people are the only things suffering. I said things, that's what we are. I guess we're critters or creatures, whatever you want to call
Absolutely.
It. But what about our vegetation, lawns, garden, and so forth?
Everything is suffering, everything. There's no watering process that can do it like Mother Nature can do it. We haven't had any water for some time now. In fact, Junior and I were just talking about that. We've got to have some water in here. Watering with city water, of course, you know, is very detrimental to the plants. It may be necessary, but, of course, watering with water that comes out of a water softener is a no-no because that water softening process is done with salt, and, of course, salt is a killer. And I tell you what, if this weather don't make you think it's time to put a shade tree in your yard, come on down and see ones I got. I got some nice ones.
Big ones. You got some shade?
Yes,
shade
sir. I got big ones. Any kind you want. From giant crepe myrtles right on down to maples of all varieties and everything.
What about lawn food or anything like that? Because this is the drought is one thing, but the growing season is still here. And my goodness, we still have another 90 days, you might say.
Yes, sir. This is time to put that fertile loam with iron out there. That'll green that lawn up real pretty. If you've got water, by all means, put the fertilizer out there. If you don't, wait till we get some rain and then put it out there.
Okay, there's a lot of things going. What are you selling most of these days, Eldon?
Surprisingly enough, and I'm really shocked that people have really gone after these kiwis. I tell you, I keep harping on them because of the demand. Every day they back up there and say, put me some kiwis in this car. And so we've continued our sale of selling you a male and a female for $7.85 apiece, and then we'll give you another female to go with it. So we've got plenty of them.
Junior sells cats that way. Yeah,
does he?
Yeah, he does. what's your tip for the day, Eldon?
I think the best tip that I can come up with right now is that so many people are coming in with plants or coming in with ideas or stories about their plants giving them problems. And I find in many cases it's because they put it right under a vent from the air conditioner.
Okay.
And that air conditioner is drying that plant out something terrible. So don't put it under the vent of an air conditioner. And don't shove it into a corner where you got all that dead air because it'll respond unfavorably.
Okay, so that's a couple of good tips for you. A little package deal from the old tree with a beard. You even trimmed the tree up a little bit.
Yeah,
it looks pretty sharp.
I put the lawnmower to it.
Okay, it looks pretty good. Haddock's Garden Center, West 23rd Street. Stop by.
Thank you, John.
Thank you, Tom, and good morning. beautiful out here at 6:30. It's only 312 degrees. We just want to introduce this 1987 Isuzu Turbo iMark, and Steve's going to tell you a little bit about it.
Tom, it's the first year the Isuzu has released the iMark in a turbo. They've had the Impulse in a turbo for a few years.
Lost the signal on Stan and Skeet, the great big satellite thing and the whole thing. We blew it. Okay. Steve and Steve. If you don't like Steve, do business with Steve. That's the way to do it. Cook White hit a Zuzu. By the way, it's a great operation. These guys have got a lot of energy, enthusiasm. Most importantly, they have the product. Before you make any decision, test drive a Zuzu and see what they have to offer for you. If it's a clean late model used car or one below $4,000, Cook White hit a Zuzu will take care of it for you. And, we hope you'll stick around. By the way, it's right now coming up 43 and a half past the hour. Just a moment, we'll be talking to Dick Van Dyke in Hollywood, so stick around with us. You know, Dick Van Dyke is a very human type individual. I think he comes across the screen that way in most anything that he's doing, whether it was on the old Mary Tyler Moore show when he is subbing for Johnny Carson or doing a host of other things. In all the series, he comes through warm, affable, and personable. I found him to be that way one-on-one when I talked to him in Hollywood. He has a special coming up tomorrow, Wednesday, here on NBC. And I would like to share the results of that interview with you, with Dick Van Dyke. And we talked about this special because it's something, it's a showcase of a little bit different variety that we think you'll appreciate. Here it is.
See me. I'm not worried about it.
I'm not worried at all. Dick, this is a long-awaited pleasure, and how are you? It's nice to see you.
Nice to see you. How are you, Tom? Although I can't see you.
No, we're working on that right now. But, you know, I'm very excited about next Wednesday's program, July 15th. But a new writer having his talent showcased, you as an actor performer, how valuable is that?
I think it's priceless. There's no way to put a value on it. It kind of gets rid of that catch-22, you know, in show business, where if you haven't had a credit, then you can't get a job. This amounts to a credit for these four aspiring young writers. And I think it's wonderful, particularly the fact that so many talented people gave so much of their time gratis to bring this thing about. It's nice to see in our business. There was the American Film Institute who started a workshop for aspiring comedy writers last year, Tom, and they had about 385 applicants, which gives you some idea of the popularity of comedy today. 12 lucky ones were picked, and a lot of good writers in the business gave their time to this workshop. And since the whole thing was kind of underwritten by the National Broadcasting Company, Brandon Tartikoff thought maybe this might make an interesting special for people to see. So four lucky writers were picked, and their material is presented on this special tonight. The other great thing is a lot of talented comedy people in the business gave of their time to be the performers. So all in all, I think it's going to be an interesting thing to watch. You just give you some idea what young writers are thinking about today, what they think is funny.
You know, this is something that you could be an authority on in any way you want to pursue it, Dick, because you've been in this thing since the 40s, you might say, the mid-40s. So you can look at a number of decades of this, and I'll quickly add you're still a young guy. I want to get that in there right quick, okay? All right.
Evidently, you're not getting a picture there.
Yeah, no, everything's fine. No, you look great. We got audio and video. I'll milk it for all it's worth.
Oh, great.
Yeah. You look great, though, but what I'm trying to say, four decades plus of seeing our taste, our comedy feelings alter. It will be interesting to see. Are most of these young guys new in the business in some form or the other?
Absolutely. None of them have done any professional work to speak of. I think one had done a little bit of professional writing. But most of them are just aspiring, just trying to get started.
Well, you know, some of the roster here now, like we're trying to put the carrot in front of the rabbit for the big program that you're hosting next Wednesday. But some of the talent that we're hearing, I mean, this is these guys can pinch themselves and say, hey, am I awake? They're actually performing my stuff. That's an exciting feeling, isn't it?
It sure is. We have John LaRoquette from Night Court, who's a great comedic performer. Jason Bateman from Valerie. Quite a few people. A favorite of mine, Kay Ballard, a great funny lady. Orson Bean. All these people gave their time to come in and perform these sketches. And several young writers said it was such a thrill to them to see their written words actually come to life in the hands of these talented people. That's what I think is great about it. It's unusual to see that in our business.
I was wondering, I checked your bio just briefly, Dick, but I was wondering, and out of these 40 years plus, actor, performer, Broadway, theater, anything that you've done, have you ever tried your hand at writing yourself?
No. I've always been involved in the writing to some extent because I've worked with people like Carl Reiner, who always listened to what the performer had to say.
Right.
And so I always got to put my lines and my ideas in. But I've never tried to sit down and write a full script. I know how difficult that is.
You're one of the busiest guys in California in the industry right now. And let's be selfish for just a moment. We're excited about the special, but I'd like to be sharing this with you. What have you got coming up in the immediate future and your plans, Dick?
Well, there is some talk, and this is really preliminary because nothing's been done about it. Some talk about my doing a new series with my own son, Barry,
uh-huh.
who is an actor. He's the new Airwolf. I don't know whether you get that down there or not.
Yeah.
But he's a good comedic actor. We may do a father and son act.
We're going to look forward to it. They're giving me a wave off, and after we got the video established, I'd like to go for a while. You know, the day's shot anyway. But, Dick, you're great to talk to, and I've enjoyed visiting with you so much. We look forward to seeing you next Wednesday.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you, Dick. Richardson Sons has been serving our community well for almost a third of a century because they're providing viable services. For example, on premises 4.5 miles north of Panama City is Panama Cabinet Manufacturing. You go in with your dimensions. There's none of the configuration of shipping or back ordering because it's right here, right now. So the bottom line, Jim Richardson can save you money. Go in with those dimensions. Let them make the cabinets for you at Panama Cabinet Manufacturing. Then you can take them with you, or you can have one of their skilled crews make the installation for you. If you're renovating right now your present kitchen or bath and vanity facilities, they have the hinges, pulls, hardware, anything that you need from a large number of manufacturers. So consequently, it's all there for you. And for the professional wood finisher, there's American Lacquer products. In fact, there's so many things, including the Westinghouse laminates, that puts them a step above. In fact, Richardson and Sons has been innovative for over 30 years in the cabinet and the countertop industry. Here's more about this operation.
When you're ready for new cabinets for your home, come to Richardson & Son Distributing. They have Northwest Florida's largest inventory of in-stock countertops, including post-formed and no-drip tops in more than 100 patterns and wood grains. They have now added the Micarta line of laminated plastics by Westinghouse. Their National Lock hardware is the perfect complement to your new cabinets. Richardson & Son also has Rockwell power tools, Porta-Cable or Bosch hand tools, and the complete convenience of Service Star hardware. Richardson & Son, Highway 231 North.
Here's Junior Lolley to sing for you.
The night is like a lovely song. Beware my foolish heart. How white the everlasting moon. Take care, my foolish heart. There's a line between love and fascination that's hard to see on an evening such as this. For they both bring the very same sensation when you're lost in the magic of a kiss. Her lips are much too close to mine. Beware my foolish heart. But if our eager lips combine, then let the fire start. For this time it is a fascination, or a dream that may fade and fall apart. It's love, this time it's love, my foolish heart.
That's pretty well our show for this morning. We thoroughly enjoyed visiting with you the past hour. By the way, we have some dignitaries coming in tomorrow. There's a gigantic boat show in town. Glassstream, including Century and other big famous makes, are at the Marriott at Bay Point. We'll be talking to the chief executive officer and a longtime dear friend of the Daybusters, Jim Taylor. But we'll be talking to Mr. A.O. Kirkland tomorrow morning, along with Jim Taylor, who'll be out with us live on the the final segment of our show tomorrow. We'll look forward to having them, plus our usual amenities going on, so we hope that you'll stick around. And that's the Daybusters for tomorrow morning here on TV7. That's it for this morning. Have a happy, safe, sane day. And for all the Daybusters, I remain sincerely yours, Tom Hips.